I feel like every time that we talk about the new political cycle, it's always the craziest and the wildest, and can you believe it? We've never seen anything like it. But I think this time might actually be the case. And of course, a lot of that has to do with Donald Trump. I think he's just completely changed everything. He's changed the way that people look at it. He's changed the way that that we assume campaigns are going to be run, the way that we assume people are going to be energized to vote. And he's kind of changed the rules of the game at the same time. Seriously, I mean, think back to like the beginning of the primary. Nobody thought Donald Trump was going to do anything. I mean, there was all these huge names. Everybody was like, oh, great, it's going to be Bush Clinton again. Remember that? Like, it's going to be Bush Clinton again. Oh, yawn. Well, Bush wasn't even a factor. I think it's been relatively quiet locally. I mean, we definitely have some of the big races. And the thing is now is that, you know, now that, like, for example, here in Fresno, Mayor Swearingen's not running for mayor again. She can't. She's termed out. And so that's going to be an interesting race. And so far, I think the primary has been pretty quiet between the – there's five people on the ballot. But once it gets down to two, if nobody reaches that 50% plus one vote mark, if nobody reaches that – and I think that will be really hard for one person to get. If nobody reaches that, once it gets down to two, I think that it might be pretty interesting. You know, Lee Brand is leaving District 6 on the Fresno City Council. He's termed out. He's running for mayor. And the race to fill his spot has actually been really interesting as well. And so we'll see what happens with this. That's one of the more abrasive races where you've actually gotten some things. You know, there was that Nazi sign controversy between Gary Bredefeld and Holly Carter. And, you know, and you got Jeremy Pierce, who's like the local like Elvis impersonator or tribute performer or however he wants. But I mean, but people laugh at that. But four councilmen, current councilmen, including the guy whose job he wants, is recommending Jeremy Pierce, the Elvis guy, for the job. They think that he's going to do the best job. And so that's interesting. And then you have like the local college student as well who's running as well. So, I mean, that's been a really interesting race. I was talking with our political show, our Sunday Morning Matters producer, Jesse, about it. And we were talking and he goes, you know, nobody from Fresno City Council or Fresno County Supervisors who is running for actual re-election, none of them are running opposed. They're all running unopposed. Nobody's taking them on. You know, and so that's pretty, really, I mean, that's pretty interesting right there. So it's like there's this fear of taking on the incumbent. But as soon as that incumbent either gets termed out or leaves, like everybody swarms to take the place. Nobody's talking about U.S. Senate, Barbara Boxer. Speaking of races where where when one person's leaving and then everybody want literally half the people in California are running to replace Barbara Boxer for Senate. There's, I think, 34 names on the ballot. I don't know if we're any different than any other city when it comes to politics. I think that, to be honest, there's a lot of surprise when everybody started showing up here. Even Trump. Trump doesn't need to come to Fresno. When he came, he'd already wrapped everything up. I think he's just trying to win big. I think he's trying to do well vote-wise here in the Valley, because even though Ted Cruz is no longer in the race, it's still, it was Ted Cruz country. We'll see how he does actually, you know, on Tuesday. But I don't think Fresno is necessarily any more political than any other place. I think that we have our issues, you know. I mean, it's water, you know. It's jobs, it's education. And when candidates talk about those things, that's what people want to hear, and that's what people will turn out for. I think it's just really interesting that California is still in play when it comes to the Democratic primary. And that has a lot of people energized and excited. And not too long ago, we were thinking it was going to be the Republican, you know, primary that was going to be the one that was driving turnout for conservatives. And now Trump's wrapped this thing up, and now it's the Democrats who are still fighting it out. It's exciting just because, you know, this is a job, but it's also fun in a way, and it's interesting, and it's engaging. And so it's a lot more fun to cover it when things are like this are going on than not, you know. It's a lot more fun. It's like, it's a lot more fun to cover a sports team when the team's winning and doing well. The whole idea of this show is to be able to, you know, have something where people can watch, be entertained, and also learn something in a quick time frame.
Yeah.
So that, at least that's what I'm trying to do. I don't, I don't want to set out to make any dry, boring show or anything like that. I don't, because I have to be on it, right?
Yeah.
I mean, I want it to be fun. I want it to be engaging. And yeah, I mean, we get serious and we talk about the issues and stuff and how they'll matter here in the Valley. But really, I mean, people need to know why this matters to them. Bottom line, I don't think that there's a lot of places where people can get information here locally,
mm-hmm.
especially through video. You know, everything is coming through Facebook nowadays. People get their news through Facebook. Obviously, the newspaper is still a fantastic resource, but when it comes to television, nobody's doing something like this on television. A local politics-only program that focuses on local politics as well.
Mm-hmm.
Because, you know, any news you watch, it's all Trump and Clinton and Bernie Sanders. But a lot of times, you know, it's not really the presidential choice that might make the biggest impact in people's lives.
Right.
You know, it's who you're electing at a local level. And what's great about it is I always just try to be that connecting voice where I make sure that they understand, even when they're arguing about something, that everybody's on the same team here when mm-hmm. it really comes down to it. Everybody wants the same things, more or less. They want a vibrant society. They want success. They want jobs. They want people to do well. And they want what's good for the community and what's good for America.
Yeah.
And being able to smile and laugh and enjoy political conversation without pointing and name-calling. I just wish we got a lot more of that. And that's what I'm trying to build with that show.